Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about noise and playback levels in your room. There's a ratio here that I found through the years that works really well for music and playback, and we're going to talk a little bit about how that all works. So room noise levels obviously are expressed in dB, and we know that dB is a unit of measure and SPL is the container in which that measurement is placed, so to speak, a pressure level. So it gives us a reference point. Now, how do we find that out? Well, there's an app that's really easy to use on your iPhone. It's called dB Meter, and you can see the icon and download it. I think it's a couple dollars, and gives you maximum pressure, gives you minimum pressure, gives you average, gives you real-time readings, and I use this a lot in rooms. And the iPhone is becoming, it's a computer, I guess. So it has speed and storage, and you can do a lot of things with the application. Most of them are accurate. They're accurate enough for readings like this. I found the microphone on the iPhone is within 1% or 2% of real accuracy compared to our lab test instruments that are right on. So it's pretty good. If you can get a device that's portable, pretty reasonably priced, and can get you within 1% or 2%, that's pretty good. So what have we found in our rooms? So if you take your iPhone and you download the dB meter, decibel meter app, I think it's called, and do some measurements in your room. And do it over a few days, do it over, different times during the day. You find that in most rooms, this is what we find. We find that 50 dB SPL is an average, no music playing in the room, just ambient background noise from traffic, etc., stuff, that 50 is a good average in your room today. 40 is really quiet. The difference between 10 dB in ambient background levels in a room is huge. And I really don't have the words or the vocabulary to describe that difference. I know it only looks like this on paper, but it's huge to your ears. And then the next level here is the 30 dB. You're not going to get that quiet level of quietness without a structure over your existing structure. So without the proper barrier and vibrational isolation stuff that you have to do. We've built rooms. I built a room in Tucson that has a 25 dB noise level. Now, what did we have to go through to get that? Two rooms, two separate foundations, 8-inch poured concrete each with 20-foot high walls and 8 inches of airspace between the two walls. And we would be able to do that if we located it out in the countryside. Our biggest problem at that point was vibrations from the earth. So the foundation, the building and the foundation were separated and put on isometric springs. So you can get this. Now at this quietness, you can sit in a chair and hear your heart. That's really quiet. So this will give you an idea of the ratios that we work with. So this is average, this is good, and this is excellent. So what do we do when we play back music in this? We always have to elevate the music and the playback levels above the noise that we're facing in our background. So the less noise we have in our room, the lower we can play our music. And the lower you play your music and the less energy you put in the room, more detail, presence, and quality of source is heard. Because energy can be confusing to our ears. Our ears are small, really not designed to handle a lot of energy. So the less energy we put in our rooms, the more we're going to hear. And if we hear more, we're going to connect more emotionally to the music. Stereophile did a popular hi-fi magazine, did a survey many, many years ago. And one of the things that caught my eye was that people actually measured the pressure levels that they listened to at. 83 was the average. So if we take that 83 SPL and we put it over our noise levels that we have in our room, let's take the good. You can see it's about 2 to 1. Okay, so that's a good kind of rule of thumb to go by. If you're 90 dB, if you're doing really loud stuff, then your background should be 45. So there's about a 2-to-1 ratio there. The lower the noise floor in your room, the more music you're going to hear. And it's subtle, and every dB that you get below 50 is a huge and dramatic impact. Now, it has a huge cost. The cost between this and this is lots of money, because now we're getting into the realm of isolation, where we have to isolate from the earth. We have to isolate from airborne energy, noise transmitted through structures. So it's really, really complicated. I was in an anechoic chamber one time in New York that had a noise floor of 21. You can imagine how quiet that was. And no reflection. So it was really discerning. Some people sit in there and they get sick because, you know, as humans, we need reflections and distance for localization to keep kind of a homeostasis, a balance, if you will. But didn't bother me. I was very interested in it. And I sat there, I think, for an hour. They had to throw me out. But it was really interesting to hear something that quiet, because I'd come close to it, but never that quiet. So you want to change this ratio in your music room in your favor, obviously within your budget. You have to do that. So if you have a 60 to a 70 dB noise level in your room, you're going to have to reduce that in order to hear music. So I hope this helps. Room ambient noise levels, playback levels, balance, ratios. You've got to keep all of it in mind. Remember, just like amplifiers, the first 25 watts of your amplifier is always going to be the best sound. The lower you get your noise levels in your room, the less energy you have to put in the room to hear more music. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.